risk for lung injury. So we know if you are at risk for a problem, sometimes preventing the problem is better than treating the problem. So we started using this approach for severe patients, patients that were receiving ECMO, very, very sick. But this is treatment. And anytime we are treating a process that's very late, it means that our chances of being successful will be much less. So why not do it early? And we did some work clinically to show that there is a ability to protect the lung and prevent lung injury from occurring in high-risk patients. But in order to understand the biology and the science, we need sometimes to go to the laboratory where we can more precisely understand what's happening in the lung and some of the interactions that are occurring. So in this model, with conventional ventilation, we can produce ARDS 100% of the time after 48 hours of conventional mechanical ventilation. So this is an ARDS model, and if we want to change the ventilation and see if we can prevent lung injury, we of course need to know that we can produce the lung injury. So this is a sepsis model, and it's for 48 hours, and we use ischemia of the gut. So we clamp the artery, the superior mesenteric artery. The entire gut is ischemic for 40 minutes, and this makes the animals very, very sick. And as I said, 100% ARDS rate, they're very unstable. They have everything that you would associate with sepsis. They receive vasoactives. They receive a lot of fluid. Now, the pigs are roughly 34 to 38 kilograms. And the fluid they receive is a total of 60 kilograms, more than the weight of the pig. And all of the animals have positive blood cultures with three organisms, three enteric organisms in their bloodstream. This is what the animal looks like in the beginning. Halfway through, you can see the shock, the malperfusion, and of course, severe edema. And this is at the end. So, this is the paper I'm presenting. We can look at the PF ratio. And here, you can see the 48 hours of the experiment. And if we look at the low tidal volume. This is low tidal volume therapy, standard of care in the U.S., applied after the PF ratio was roughly 300. Essentially, very much like the clinical approach, where you apply this after you have some degree of lung injury. Here is the low tidal volume group. You can see they develop by blood gas, ARDS. So we were not able to change the course by doing this. You have a control group, which is not septic, and you have the APRD group, and you can see the PF ratio stays very stable. In fact, these animals are 21% oxygen room air at the end of the 48-hour experiment. These animals are on 100%. If we look at compliance, because we know when the lung is edematous and you have edema and collapsed lung, the compliance will decrease. And you can see that the compliance of the low tidal volume group goes down. The compliance of the APRB group stays actually very high. So let's look at the lungs after 48 hours. This is the low tidal volume group with an inflation of 25 centimeters, which means really, we should be at total lung capacity. Here is the APRB lungs at 25 centimeters in volume. Actually has the highest IL-6 level in the VAR. Let's look at surfactant, because we know surfactant is important, not just for surfactant. That means we can stop all the other things that come behind it. In other words, if you stop a problem at its very root,